I'm Ven Gopal, Gain Financial Advice. So today our topic is how to gain good marks in CA Foundation Level Paper 1, that is Principles and Practice of Accounting. So in order to get a good marks in CA Foundation Level Paper 1, you need to have a strong knowledge on CA Foundation Level and preparation need to be done thoroughly. So for that you need to have a guidance. So for that guidance I am creating this video. So in this video, we are going to divide this video into small parts, that is question paper pattern, and second part will be so chapter wise weightage analysis of last 3 year papers, and the final third one chart presentation, fourth one what are the materials required to be completed before attempting your CA foundation level exam. So these are the parts we are going to cover in the entire video session. So please watch complete video, you will get some knowledge on CA Foundation Level Paper 1. Okay, let's get into the topic, question paper pattern. So in your CA Foundation Paper 1, so you are having total 6 questions. That 6 questions, question number 1 is compulsory. So that question number 1 divided into so 6 true or false statements and 2 4 mark questions, which is compulsory. You don't have any choice for this question, so you have to attend this question compulsory. If you skip this question, you will be losing 20 marks, so you are going to write for balance 80 marks only. So this means question number 1 is very very compulsory, so you don't have any choice for this. So 6 true or false statements you have to attend, and 2 4 mark questions also you have to attend. If you didn't attend this question number 1, then you are going to lose 20 marks. So why? Because remaining 5 questions you are allowed to write only 4. If you write 5 questions also, they will consider 4 only. So for that reason, so question number 1 is compulsory, you have to complete this question number 1. Okay, so remaining 5 questions you are having. So first question compulsory, after completing the first question you are having 5 questions balance. So in that 5 questions you have to answer for only 4 questions. So 4 questions, so each question will be having total 20 marks. It will be combination of 10 marks, 5 marks, 6 marks, or 5 plus 5 plus 10. So like that it will be divided. So you have to answer only 4 questions out of 5 questions. From 2 to 6 there will be 5 questions, but you have to answer only 4 questions. So after completing question number 1 compulsory, remaining 5 questions will be there. In that 5 you have to answer only 4 questions only. Okay. Okay, now we can analyze the actual weights allotted to each chapter wise. So by taking last 3 years question papers. So each year having 2 exams, that is May exam and November exam. So almost 6 papers we are going to analyze it. So let's get into that. Okay, now let's we start. Okay, we are taking 2020 year and 2019 and 2018. So 3 year question papers we are taking, 3 years question papers, that is May exam, November exam, May exam, November exam. But in 2020, due to COVID-19, there is no May exam. In November only one exam conducted. After that cycle 2, that is January 2021, they conducted this. Now we are considering that also for 2020 year. So these are the 6 question papers we are analyzing the patterns. So before that, there is one amendment before writing your exams. That is, so previously there is a ratio analysis and joint venture. These 2 chapters are there. So ratio analysis are highest weightage in the world exams, but it is removed. So right, so for the reason I am highlighting that here. And joint venture also removed from your syllabus, so it is also not there in your syllabus. These 2 things you have to consider. So remaining all there in your syllabus, so we are going to see each and every one chapter. So first we are considering final accounts. So see, final accounts subdivided into manufacturing entities and non-manufacturing entities. So manufacturing entities, so last 6 question papers they asked only 15 marks, 2 attempts. So So November 2020 and 2019 November attempt, they asked 15 marks. In case of manufacturing, say non-manufacturing concern, so they are asking every time they are asking 10, at least they are asking 10 marks, 5 marks here, 20, 10, 10, here 5. So that is put together manufacturing and non-manufacturing, put together they are having a weightage of 15 marks. See here 15 marks and see here 10 marks, here 15 marks, 20 and 15 marks. So every year they are focusing 15 marks from final accounts. So that is manufacturing entity 5 marks and non-manufacturing entities 10 marks. So in case of company accounts, next topic, company accounts, see every time they are asking average of 15 marks except 2018, so there is 10 marks. So remaining all years they are covering 15 marks from this question, company accounts. So you have to very careful on this. So you have to get good marks in your CA foundation paper 1. So you have to be very thorough with this company accounts. After that, non-profit organization. See, non-profit organization having also same level of weightage. So 10, at least 25, 10, 10, 10 every year. So that means every year they are asking 10 mark question from the non-profit organization, except November 2021 cycle 2, they requested 25 marks from this chapter. So it is having highest weightage in a module 2, company accounts and non-profit organization. So here approximately final accounts itself having 15 marks, company accounts having 15 marks and non-profit organization having 10 marks around. So 40 marks we covered. In case of partnership, so they are asking 10 marks every time, they are asking 10 marks. See, so from death and retirement they are focusing on these two only. See, last 2018 they asked a question from admission, after that they are asking question from retirement and death. So these two topics only they are covering from last four question papers, five question papers. So it means, so it is very very important for your partnership level, retirement and death, these two things you have to cover. So these are the weightage for module 2. So in case of module 2, total weights allotted is around 50 to 55 marks. So that marks divided into final accounts 15, company accounts 15, non-profit organization 10 and partnership 10. So around 50 marks weightage for your module 2. So you have to be clear on these topics. In case of module 1, we can see that bank reconciliation statement, every time they are asking 10, 10, every time they are asking 10 mark question from BRS, and rectification of error also 5 marks, 10 marks, 10 marks, 14, 10. So average they are also looking into this, rectification of errors also 10 marks. So these two chapters are having highest weightage in module 1. After this, consignment, in case of accounting for special transaction is there. So in that chapter we are having consignment, bills of exchange, so sale of goods and approval are written basis and average due date and account current. So among these chapters, consignment is frequently rising question. See, every time they are asking question for 10 marks consignment. After consignment, average due date and account current, these two topics are covering 5 marks every time they are asking question. So these two topics also very very important, around 15 marks the three topic itself having weightage. And sale of goods on approval or written basis and bills of exchange, so very rarely asking from these. So in three chapters you have to be very clear on this in case of module 1. So module 1 you need to be clear on 5 topics, that is bank reconciliation statements, rectification of errors, consignment, average due date, account current. So these are the 5 topics you need to be clear. So after that you have to be focusing on depreciation. Depreciation also having average weightage of 10 marks. Last, after removing ratios, they are giving some weightage to depreciation. So depreciation also having some weight on this, so we have to give weight to the depreciation also. So this is what about module 1. So remaining all very rarely asking questions. So these 5 topics you need to be very clear before going to your exams, right? The same previous year tabular data is presented in chart, okay? So that is chapter wise total marks from the last 6 attempts. So if you are considering final accounts 65 marks, company accounts 85 marks, non-profit organization 65 marks, partnership 70, bank reconciliation statements 54, rectification of errors 53, depreciation 33, and consignment 45, average due date 30, account current 25. These two chapters are 5 mark questions. This chapter is 10 mark question. That means they are focusing every time these three chapters and depreciation as well. So you have to be clear on this. So 5 topics you have to be very clear. So this is the total marks from the last 6 question papers for each chapter wise. Manufacturing, non-manufacturing entities, company accounts, non-profit organizations, partnership. So chapter wise I have given here. So see that. Okay, so this is all weights. Based on these weights, I am giving highest importance to first company accounts, second thing is non-profit organization, third one, so final accounts. So in final accounts, both manufacturing and non-manufacturing will be covering, and partnership. Okay, in case of module 1, so prior importance given to, so BRS, after that rectification of errors, consignment, average due date, account current, depreciation. So these are the topics you need to be clear in order to gain good marks in your CA foundation level paper 1. Okay. So students, after completing all analysis, so they might be looking what are the materials to be covered to get good marks and as well as conceptual understanding. So for that, so students are looking for some private authors and they are looking for some other things as well, their institute materials, whatever they, wherever they are learning some courses. Okay. So when comparing all these things for CA foundation level paper 1, so these are the 4 materials more than enough for getting, you are getting 100 marks as well from this after 4. So after completing all these 4, that is, first one is ICAI study material, so which you receive when you are registering for CA foundation level. So for suggested answers, so it will be available printed copies in ICAI website as well as in your nearby ICAI service center. Okay, ICAI center, right? Mock test papers it will be conducting every time. So for every attempt they are giving 2 mock test papers, that is mock test 1 and mock test 2. So 2 test papers they are conducting for CA students, and revision test papers before, so exam scheduling. So ICAI institute will release RTPs, revision test papers. So these are the 4 materials you have to cover before attempting your CA foundation level paper 1 exam. So first importance will be given to study materials, second one suggested answers, that is nothing but previous year exam question and answers, both will be there, and the third one mock test papers, so it's a sample copy of exam, so it will be conducted by ICAI institute, so question will be prepared by the proper question paper setters only, and revision test papers which is also issued by the institute only. So these are the 4 materials students has to complete their preparation. So these are the 4 materials is more than enough to getting 100 marks itself. So no need to look for any another material, you need to complete each and every question from these 4 materials, then it is more than enough to score 100 marks. I'm saying, repeating my words, that is 100 marks. So for 100 marks, these 4 materials are more than enough to score 100 marks itself. Okay. So this is all about materials to be covered by the each student before attempting their CA foundation level. That is study material, suggested answer, mock test papers, revision test papers. So instead of buying all these different books and by reading half of the books, that is not at all good. So complete all these 4 books so before writing your CA foundation level exam. Thank you for watching the whole video. I hope you understand what are the topics to be covered and what are the materials to be followed for your paper 1 CA foundation level exam. So thank you. Your Venu signing off. GFA, Gain Financial Advice. Thank you.